Okay, everybody ready?
Yep.
So, good afternoon. Yeah, we just wanted to bring some information out from the individual that was found in the Cannonball River yesterday afternoon. We received a report, a 911 call of a possible body that was floating in the river. Morton County deputies and myself responded down to that area, and there was a male victim that was found in the Cannonball River along the north shore. Once the individual was removed from the water, he did have an identification card on him. And the identification card was from the Republic of Macedonia. At that point, from the information we had, the autopsy, or the body was then transported to the medical examiner's office in Bismarck for the autopsy, and the autopsy was performed this morning. So that's the information that we have right now. The biggest thing was trying to locate family and next of kin from the information that that we had from the ID card, and following up on that.
So what's taking place now, I guess? You know, what are the next steps in this investigation?
Well, right now we're there's a couple things we need to rule out, and that is if there was any foul play involved. You know, exactly trying to find out what happened, and with that we are having a hard time. Once we ran the individual in our system, he did come back as a missing person from Glendale, California. With that information, I did contact the Glendale PD and talk to them, and we tried to find the next of kin. And what we found was a close friend of his and another cousin that was in New Jersey, and the rest of the family was back in Macedonia. So that took a long time before we could verify that and then make sure that the family was notified before we released the name.
So back, I believe it was October 30th, the Sheriff's Department, along with some other agencies, were conducting a search for someone who possibly drowned. Do you believe this to be the person who you were searching for that day?
No, I don't believe so. I think it's, at that point, we did go down there, and then from some of the information we have from BIA, that there was not an actual person that was in the water. And I believe from the body condition of the subject that was found, that it wasn't that long of a time period that the victim was in the water. So really what we're trying to find out and follow up on right now is if he used any credit cards. We also have found the vehicle when he rented it, and that it was found down at the camp. And that vehicle has since been, you know, impounded since February 23rd, and then now is in Minneapolis. So we contacted the Ramsey County Sheriff's Office in Minneapolis to go to see if they could locate the vehicle to find out if any personal property was in that vehicle yet at this point, because it was a rental vehicle. So really what I'm asking for is also from the public or anybody who knows whereabouts of the deceased from October 29th of 2016 until April 9th of 2017. There's a period in there where the family and friends had no contact with him, and that's why we were following up on any use of credit cards or things of that nature. And right now, we have nothing between those two time frames to be able to place him where he was at.
So, do you know when the vehicle was rented?
The vehicle was rented on October 26th from Glendale, California.
Okay, so no credit card usage or anything like that?
No.
To give us an indicator.
And we know we drove from Glendale, California to South Dakota, because he was stopped on October 28th in South Dakota and issued a speeding ticket. And from the information we got from South Dakota is that He was traveling very lightly, was by himself, and was headed to the protest camp.
Do we know anything about like occupation, like what he did, you know, why he was there? Do you know anything about that yet, or?
There's some preliminary information we know, that he possibly went to UCLA and went to school, and he also was a Lyft driver out in California. So that's the last thing, and then, you know, family and friends, or the last contact with him with family or friends was out in California before October 26th. So we know that, you know, he came from California, he rented the vehicle there, he drove, this far to South Dakota, was issued a citation, was at the protest camp because the vehicle that he rented out in California was impounded from the protest camp. That vehicle was then taken to Bismarck at the impound lot, and has since that time and before this was known, that vehicle was picked up by the rental company and taken to Minneapolis. So that's why we're following up on the Minneapolis to see if there's any information or personal property left in that vehicle. Other than that, we really don't have a lot of information between them two dates.
Do you, can you at all give us a time frame as to when this person might have died? I know you said it seemed like it was somewhat recently. It may not have been months and months ago.
I don't think it was, just because also he was, when he was located, he was only wearing a t-shirt, blue jeans, and had tennis shoes on. So it would be, hard stretch to figure that he was out in real cold temperatures during that time. The other possibility is that we were looking at is, one is we wanted to rule out or rule in foul play, if that was the case, but there was no, from the coroner's from the medical examiner's examination, there was no trauma done to the body that would suspect any foul play at this point. The other possibility is that he was walking on the thin ice on the Cannonball River and then just fell through and couldn't get out. So that's, and that could have been, you know, the time frame in March when it was nicer weather, and the ice would have been thin at that time. So we're really trying to figure the timelines down, even by the credit cards, the last time they were used, or by anybody who has had contact with him, you know, at the camps after October 9th and before April 9th.
And then where was the location where this person was found? I know the Cannonball River, but where exactly down there?
It was on the north shore of the Cannonball River, approximately 300 yards west of the mouth of the Missouri. So if you're familiar with the area and where 1806 is, you have 1806 Turtle Hill, and it would have been east of Turtle Hill and west of the mouth of the Missouri River.
Is that north of the protest camp?
It'd be northeast of the protest camp, yes.
And do you know how to say this person's name?
I do not.
We were trying to figure it out ourselves.
Yeah.
Well,
Damjan Nedelkovski.
Yeah, it's just Nedelkovski.
I'm thinking phonetically.
And Damjan is his first name, so it's Damjan Nedelkovski.
I know this has been asked, but do you have any kind of a general time frame of when his body might have been in the water?
No, and from what the medical examiner has stated too, he said there is no way to determine how long the body was in the water at this point.
Is the thought that it surfaced when the ice melted?
Well, it's just my, thoughts about dealing with this in the past and with individuals who have been in water, is that the body didn't have enough decomposition to be in the water for a 5-month period of time, so.
What identifications were found?
He had his ID. There was an ID from the Republic of Macedonia. And also he had credit cards with his name on it. And that's how we ended up getting an initial ID on him. And we're still trying to follow up with the dental records and with the fingerprints at this point.
Will the body be sent?
Yes, I talked with the U.S. Embassy or out of Washington, D.C., with the Macedonia. And there is some, most likely that the remains will be transported back to Macedonia, because that's where his mother and brother are at this point. I think that's the only family that we know of. So arrangements are pending for that to happen.
Had you guys known that he had been missing? I mean, had that been reported to your department, or was that news to you when you found out about his body?
That was the first time when we ran his name and he came up as a NCIC hit. That's the first time that we were aware of that he was, I guess, in this area and was missing.
So did his parents or did family know that he was here, or?
No, they from information from his a close friend out in Glendale is that. Says after October 29th, he basically kind of disappeared from having any contact with them, and have been, and that's why the family got together and made the missing persons report on November 16th of 2016, because they had no contact with him since that time and have not heard from him until they received the call from him.
So if you don't think the body was in the river that long, and the missing persons report was filed on October 29th, you've got 4 months of where was this person if he hadn't immediately died after October 29th.
And that's what we're trying to figure out. And that's why if anybody knows any whereabouts where, after October 29th where he was, and you know, it's possible that he did disappear, you know, or fell victim shortly after that. But there's a lot of circumstances that we're trying to figure out. It's just that we would like to narrow down that time frame if anybody knows any, you know, whereabouts during that time.
And
There was a possibility that a cousin identified him, and he said he watched some of the protest video and thought that he might have seen him from a protest on February 2nd, but we can't verify that. He just said it looked very familiar to him, but he wasn't 100% sure that was him. So that is the only other real information that we had between October 29th or October 28th, when he was actually stopped by a deputy in South Dakota, and him possibly being seen at the camp on video on February 2nd, that's really the only two time frames that we have, and we're not sure about the February 2nd.
So you don't have any credit card documentation that he used his credit card between those 2 4-month dates? So
no, we are in the process of subpoenaing we have to subpoena the records for the credit cards, and that we are in the process of doing at this point. So no, right now we don't know, and that's what we're trying to figure out.
So that could give you a lot more clues.
It could, yes.
When do you think you'll have that credit card information?
Well, we're hoping if we can get a subpoena to him by at least by tomorrow, it won't take very long to get the records.
So what happens if it comes back with no returns on a credit card?
That's the biggest thing, is that we just don't know the whereabouts from that October 29th until April 9th, and we are trying to gather any information or look at any possibility that we can that anybody has seen him during that time frame.
The area where he was found, along the shore area where he was found, was that Cannonball Ranch property? Was that core property?
It's on core land.
Core land.
U.S. core land, yes.
Did anyone you spoke with give you an indication of what would have brought him to the protest camp?
No, and even I don't think the family really knew that he came here. From the information I have from the close friend, he said that he did talk to him when he was in California, and then he just kind of vanished from any contact from friends or family. And after that point, we know he would come this way because of the rental, because of the traffic stop, and that rental vehicle ended up at the protest camp. But from the information that I have so far at this point, he had never told friends or family that he was coming to this location.
And he was a Macedonian citizen, wasn't a U.S. citizen?
He originally is from Macedonia, had the Macedonia ID, but however, he had ties to California and Glendale. But whether he is a citizen at this point, I do not know.
He was a resident of Glendale?
Yes. And I'm guessing immigration can't, tell us some information on it, but I'm guessing that because he went to school in California and worked in California, that he became either a naturalized citizen of the U.S.
Kyle, I don't know if you've already said this, but what was exactly found on him when he was found?
The only thing on that he had a t-shirt on, blue jeans, tennis shoes, and his wallet was in his right side pants pocket.
So no kind of phone or anything like that?
No.
Can you tell us anything about the family's reaction?
When I talked to the close friend this morning, he was very surprised and obviously was distraught about it. And he was looking for his friend since the end of October. And this is the first word that he received of that. Also, I received a call from a cousin that lives in the United States. And he was about had the same reaction, was very distraught and wanted to know anything that they could do. And my request was from him was to make sure that he had contact with the family in Macedonia, that was taken care of so we could get the next of kin notified. And that has been done, and we also have talked to the the Macedonia and the U.S. Embassy in trying to make sure that the parents get all the information that's available.
That's my last one. It says on the release, the stepbrother filed a missing persons report in Glendale.
I'm sorry, I missed that part.
It says his stepbrother?
His stepbrother reported him missing.
Okay, we haven't.
But the stepbrother, from my understanding, the father is deceased, but the mother and the stepbrother are in Macedonia.
Oh, okay.
The only family he has is a close friend that lives in Glendale, California, and a cousin that's in New Jersey. Thank you.
Okay.